Hi, Cancer. Welcome to your June 2019 Astro Update. It's Raina here. So, Cancer, as you probably know, for some of you, this is your birthday month. So, happy birthday to that first decanate of Cancer, the first 10 degrees. And this is going to officially happen, the sun going into your sign on the solstice. I wrote S-O-U-L, the solstice, on June 21st. And so the solstice is not always on the 21st, but it's always around that time. And so this is a powerful time of the year when the sun goes into a cardinal sign. And so before that, the sun is in your 12th house in Gemini. So this may be a time when you feel like being, I was going to say a couch potato, but actually, I mean, being in some kind of hibernation period. And there are other planets. I mean, this is like a month of contrasts where you have some energy in the 12th house and some in the first house. And you are going to have planets come from the 12th to the first, but also go from the 11th to the 12th. The 12th house is the last house. So that's kind of unfinished business. And then you have the debut of the first house in Cancer. So it's like endings and beginnings. And just when I say endings, it's not really about, okay, this is done, but really like, can we get this resolved? Because it's very, in the 12th house, it's very much undercover. It's like your dream time. It's your past life exploration, or the hints you have that you have experienced certain things before, the people that you've known. And, because it's ruled by Pisces, it's a water house. And you understand that energy very well since you're a water sign. But it still doesn't make it necessarily that easy to have transits in the 12th house for anybody. Because there's always like this part of us that is saying, okay, what's really going on here? How can I really understand how I feel when it could go back like 2000 years? Like, how can I deal with this? So anyway, all month we have Mars in your sign. So in that first house, you may even feel like you want to do something vigorous. The first house can be the body. So you may want to start working out if you've not done it before, or if you've kind of, slacked off from doing that. And there's just like this energy pulsing through you. And that can kind of balance out the fact that the sun is in the 12th house, I feel, because Mars can really drive things and push you into taking action. But also, you have to watch out for being too pushy. You know, we talk about pushing, but being pushy, because Mars is a take charge kind of a planet, and it's in a cardinal sign. It's in Cancer. So it's already in activity mode, being in Cancer. And you are a sign, being one of the four cardinal signs, and the other cardinal signs are your opposite sign, Capricorn, Aries, and Libra. These are all cardinal signs, and they like to do, they're like the doers. They're the people that initiate. And, maybe saying doer, that's confusing, because, you know, fixed signs and mutable signs do things. It's just that initiation. And so you can notice, and I have observed many cardinal signs in my day, and how they tend to like to, you know, take classes and to go certain places, because they're always on the lookout for more that they can accomplish. And, you know, so there's, I think it's fair to say that there's quite an ambitious streak that runs through cardinal signs, but just in terms of even restlessness, you know, wanting to take some kind of action about everything that they feel is not where it should be. And sometimes you do have to allow things to play out and not try to interfere. It's hard sometimes to know when is the time, you know, to lay back and not do something, and when is the time to really plow in. But in any case, you are going to be very energetic and confident, and to the point maybe sometimes of cockiness, although I'm sure most Cancer people won't have to worry about that. And then on the 3rd, there's a new moon in Gemini, that 12th house. So a new moon in the spiritual house, you may feel like you're going to take up yoga if you haven't done so. Sometimes, you know, just watch how you feel at the time of that new moon and see how it's influencing you. I've had to do this over again. And one of the things I was saying the first time around is that the 12th house can be the house of self-undoing, or the ways that we trip ourselves up, you know, how we get in our own way. And so usually when there's like a full moon in the 12th house, it's a natural time to let go of those addictions, for instance, which the 12th house can be about. And yet I could totally see the new moon in the 12th house accomplishing the same thing, like turning over a new leaf and saying, I'm no longer going to escape my problems by picking up the bottle. I'm going to realize that that's not going to solve anything. And just maybe create a new game plan for yourself on how you can deal with the stressors that may have led to that. The 12th house can be the house of illusion and escapism. And so addictions certainly fall in line with that emotion, if you will, or the mindset of wanting to escape. On the 4th, we have Mercury going into your sign. So Mercury is joining Mars, and this makes you very, maybe even like forthright in your opinions, but definitely consistent with who you are as an individual, where you can communicate who you are in a very concise way. And this is great if you are looking for work and you need to like sell yourself to a future boss and to tell them who you are, what you're about, what your skill set is. Having Mars in that first house can do wonders, because, you know, I see Cancer as a rather shy sign, reticent, a little bit, maybe a little bit, you know, very sensitive, vulnerable. And especially if your rising sign is Cancer, this is what others may see. If your sun sign is Cancer, but your rising sign is Leo, you may write to me and say, you don't know what you're talking about. I'm not unsure of myself. It's not so much being unsure. I think it's being vulnerable and not wanting to make a fool out of yourself. Like, you're very sensitive to being perceived in a certain way, and that can lead to that tentative nature. But I feel like you have the ability to also go after what you want. And with Mars in your first house, I think you're going to feel a lot more sure of yourself and your ideals and not be afraid to promote them. And so this can be, again, when I was talking about selling yourself, this can be very good for having to maybe multiple times if you're looking for work, give a synopsis of what you're about, what your skill set is, and what you're going to do. And it could even be like knowing what your financial situation is, crunching the numbers, thinking about it. Mercury is your mindset, and you may be getting in control of your finances simply by knowing what's going in and going out more. On the 8th, Venus goes into Gemini, that 12th house. So Venus is in the 11th house of friendships for the first week of June, Cancer. And that could mean that perhaps some of you are, you know, schmoozing with friends, and perhaps you meet somebody, and that person could be a great deal older, and you are simply beaming from ear to ear. You're very happy about this relationship, and other people have a problem with it. But actually, what I meant to say is that if there's some reason that this relationship is unusual, and you may have like a circle of friends, and for some reason, if you meet somebody through that circle of friends, maybe there's an age difference, or maybe there's some other reason why you want to keep that relationship hidden. The 12th house is you having a romance with somebody, and it's clandestine. And you may be anticipating that other people would have a problem with this relationship rather than it actually being a problem at this time. And the other thing too is, again, if one or both of you are married having a primary relationship, and you think other people wouldn't approve of that. So the other thing with Venus in the 12th house is it could be like a soulmate, somebody that you meet that, you know, seems very familiar when you first meet them. And then you're just like really connecting that this person and you have had many dalliances and many lifetimes together. And that's why they feel so familiar. And it's like that connection is the spiritual part of it, that recognition, I should say. And on the 17th, we have a full moon at 25 degrees of Sagittarius. This is your sixth house of health and work. This is why I had to start the reading over again, because I said it was the 8th house, and then I'm like, oh boy, here I go. And so this could be like, if this is the workplace, there might be something that comes to a head. And if you have Mars in the first house, Cancer, you may have been putting up with something for a long time, and then, you know, you're loaded for bear. Remember when, you know, you've probably know people, and maybe you're like this, where you take something, you take a lot of crap, and then you're just like on the war path. And Mars is the god of war. So you may have like looked the other way about something, and then all of a sudden you're just a complete hellcat. And you're just, you can't really be placated anymore, because you took it for so long. So something could come to a head, but something could come to culmination. Maybe you've been working on something and you get a promotion, you get a raise or something along those lines. So either you quit, get laid off, quit, or get promoted. Anything that forces some kind of awareness about the workplace. And So that's very interesting as well. That's right before the solstice. So there's a lot of, you know, energy that builds up, you know, right at that time when we have these great changes. There's a, just like, and it's a full moon too. So that makes it very powerful in its own right. So then on the 21st, we have the sun going into that first house. And on the same day, Neptune retrogrades. And Neptune is in Pisces, and it's in your ninth house. So it's compatible with you being in the fellow water element. But in the ninth house, when Neptune retrogrades, it can kind of pull the curtain open when it comes to any kind of illusion that you have had about a particular matter. And that can, you know, sometimes appear very harsh if you've been kind of fantasizing about something. So for instance, if there is some kind of like something to do with university, whether it's teaching or learning, and you were kind of like, this is going to be the most amazing thing. Maybe you have gotten your degree, because it is June. That's when a lot of people graduate. And you thought there'd be all these people beating down their door to hire you. And you realize it's not that simple, that it doesn't necessarily happen like that. And then you start to be disillusioned by the academic experience because you feel like, where did it get me? You know, what do I have to show for it? This was the whole reason I did this, is so that I could have the pick of all these jobs. And it just seems like it's a daunting process. Or you want to go on a trip, and maybe you thought you were going to have enough money, and then something happened, and then you say to yourself, who am I kidding? I don't have enough money. And you just kind of think you're being so practical and you're on top of things. And really, you kind of got, you know, I don't want to say bitter, but definitely disappointed by the turn of events. And so that's what can happen, because Neptune is such a manufacturer of illusion that Neptune retrograde can take away some of those illusions. And if the person has an escapist mentality to begin with, that can feel that much more of an illusion and a letdown. I think that's the important thing, a letdown. But it can make, you know, certain things less vague. Like, so if you were trying to apply to school and maybe you felt like it was very hard to navigate, and then something comes along to simplify it. Yeah, there's many possibilities. On the 26th, Mercury goes into Leo, the second house. I meant third. The third house, and that is that's where Mercury rules the third house. Oh, no, I'm sorry, the second house. I'm wondering why did I say something that was wrong about Mercury before? I thought I said that. I thought I was talking about crunching the numbers and seeing where everything is. So why did I, very strange. Well, if I said anything earlier where I was mentioning Mercury going into second house, it's not until the 26th. Mercury goes into your sign earlier in the month, on the 4th of the month. So not sure if I was thinking of my last recording, but Mercury in the second house can make you very aware of your budget, of what you need to do, to maybe like coming up with ideas of other income streams. And that can be great for increasing, building your wealth. And this is the second house is also the house of self-esteem. So thinking about how your feelings about yourself have influenced your life, there may be other things going on that are kind of highlighting this and making it necessary for you to be thinking about this, including like a work situation where, like I said, on the 17th, you may something may come to a head, and you may, maybe you're looking at yourself, you know, what could I have done differently to make this go a different way? Mercury in Leo in that second house can mean if you are in between jobs that you're trying to see, you know, how can I kind of get some money in the meantime? How can I live most efficiently? And, you know, in terms of a budget, creating one or maintaining one. But yeah, I think that it's a time of great self-focus, but also the spiritual part of things is present as well. And the reason, Cancer, I think this is wonderful is because it's easy to think that we are doing everything. And I do believe that we should accept responsibility for our life. But I also feel like we have to flow with whatever is the influences are outside of ourselves as well, to be able to get like a good balance in life. And also value that part of life. So in any case, I hope that you enjoyed this. And I have a special offer for those who are born under the sign of Cancer. I'm offering this to Geminis as well. And it is ...22% off all natal chart interpretations. And the only thing is, this is not going to be put on my website, and I don't have a coupon code that I've developed yet. Look under the video to see if I've developed a coupon code yet, or you can just contact me at rainamoonastrology@gmail.com if you would like to take advantage of that. And it'll be through the end of June that this is offered, of 2019, obviously. You know, there's always those people that try to find the loophole. I used to work retail, so I know about that, bringing in expired coupons and the whole bit. But so the other thing is, this has to be for somebody who is born under the sign of Cancer or Gemini. And so anyway, I hope you have a wonderful month and take care. Bye.